is the lamp unto my faith, and I light unto my path. Thy word is the lamp unto my feet, and I light unto my path.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 16, verses 1 to 15. The word of the Lord came to me. Mortal, make known to Jerusalem her abominations, and say, thus says the Lord God to Jerusalem, your origin and your birth were in the land of the Canaanites. Your father was an Amorite, and your mother a Hittite. As for your birth, on the day you were born, your navel cord was not cut, nor were you washed with water to cleanse you, nor rubbed with salt, nor wrapped in cloths. No eye pitied you to do any of these things for you out of compassion for you, but you were thrown out in the open field, for you were abhorred on the day you were born. I passed you and saw you flailing about in your blood. As you lay in your blood, I said to you, live and grow up like a plant of the field. You grew up and became tall and arrived at full womanhood. Your breasts were formed and your hair had grown, yet you were naked and bare. I passed by you again and looked on you. You were at the age for love. I spread the edge of my cloak over you and covered your nakedness. I pledged myself to you and entered into a covenant with you, says the Lord God, and you became mine. Then I bathed you with water and washed off the blood from you and anointed you with oil. I clothed you with embroidered cloth and with sandals of fine leather. I bound you in fine linen and covered you with rich fabric. I adorned you with ornaments. I put bracelets on your arms, a chain on your neck, a ring on your nose, earrings in your ears, and a beautiful crown up your head. You were adorned with gold and silver. While your clothing was of fine linen, rich fabric, and embroidered cloth, you had choice flour and honey and oil for food. You grew exceedingly beautiful, fit to be a queen. Your fame spread among the nations on account of your beauty, for it was perfect because of my splendor that I had bestowed on you, says the Lord God. But you trusted in your beauty and played the whore because of your fame and lavished your whorings on any passerby. The word of the Lord.
Today, the Holy Mother Church celebrates the memory of Saint Maximilian Kolbe. He's been known for his heroic charity in giving life to his own inmate in prison. Let us move on to the Word of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Some Pharisees came to him and tried to trap him by asking, "Does our law allow a man to divorce his wife for whatever reason he wishes?" Jesus answered, "Haven't you read the scripture that says that in the beginning the Creator made people male and female? And God said, 'For this reason a man will leave his father and mother and unite with his wife, and the two will become one.' So they are no longer two, but one. No human being must separate then what God has joined together." The Pharisees asked him, "Why then did Moses give the law for a man to hand his wife a divorce notice and send her away?" Jesus said, Moses gave you permission to divorce your wives because you are so hard to teach. But it was not like that at the time of creation. I tell you then that any man who divorces his wife for any cause other than her unfaithfulness commits adultery if he marries some other woman. His disciples said to him, "If this is how it is between a man and his wife, it is better not to marry." Jesus answered, "This teaching does not apply to everyone, but only to those to whom God has given it. For there are different reasons why men cannot marry, some because they were born that way, others because men made them that way, and others do not marry for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. Let him who can accept this teaching do so." The Gospel of our Lord. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, today most of us are used to a throwaway culture. If something doesn't work, we put it away, we discard it, because today it is more profitable to get something new rather than repairing the old one. So most of the electronic items, when it is broken, we discard it and go for a new one. And this attitude has come into our relationships also. Today, we see in the society the high rate of divorces. When a man and woman comes under one roof, as they begin their life together, as soon as they find a mismatch between them, they try to separate. And it is the same case as laity when we deal with the church. If there is some misunderstanding, some would avoid going to church just because of a misunderstanding. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, today Jesus addresses this attitude. He warns us to be more concerned in our relationships, especially in the marital relationships between a man and a woman. Today we see how many children suffering due to broken families, as their parents have separated. So many children suffer. And today, Jesus wants us to reflect on our relationships. Are we committed? Today, many of us are not willing to commit ourselves in relationships. Even if we take into consideration at our work level, in our occupations, in our professions, if we are not feeling okay, we don't want to commit ourselves. We move from them. And even in marriage life, sometimes today's youngsters very easily move away from their commitments. And today, we need to think about this very gravely. Are we committed in our relationships? God the Almighty has given each and every one of us a role to play, a special role to be played in our families, at our workplaces, in our society. We need to be committed in it. If it is so, we have to be faithful in our dealings. Therefore, let us think about our commitment and faithfulness in our relationships. God bless you.